Bone is a specialized form of connective tissue that consists of cells and intercellular material. Osteoblasts, osteocytes, and osteoclasts make up the cells of the bone, while the intercellular material is made of organic and inorganic material. By dry weight, bone comprises of 33% organic matrix, with 28% representing type 1 collagen, and non-collagenous proteins like bone siloprotein, osteocalcin, osteopontin, osteonectin, and proteoglycans making up the rest of the 5%. The organic matrix is mineralized by hydroxyapatite that make up the inorganic material and comprises the rest of the 67% of bone by dry weight. Though bone can be classified into different types based on its shape as long, short, flat, or irregular, most bones are essentially made of two tissue patterns called compact or cortical bone and cancellous or spongy trabecular bone. So let's have a look at the histology of bone with the mandible as an example. Now the mandible has a rigid outer cortical bone or cortex forming an outer shell surrounding a medullary cavity or a marrow cavity. The medullary cavity, apart from housing the bone marrow, is interrupted by a network of numerous bony spicules or trabeculae called the cancellous bone or the spongy bone. The cortical and cancellous bones are histologically identical in that they are made of concentric sheets of collagen called lamellae. Histologically, three types of lamellae can be identified in the compact bone, them being the circumferential lamellae, the concentric lamellae, and the interstitial lamellae. Bulk of the compact bone is made of concentric lamellae that are actually bony layers wrapped around a central cylindrical tunnel or canal. The central canal is called the Haversian canal and houses blood vessels and nerves. The Haversian canal and the concentric lamellae together form the Haversian system. And the Haversian system forms the basic metabolic unit of bone called the osteon. Circumferential lamellae surround the outermost and the innermost layers of the compact bone. And the lamellae found in between concentric lamellae are called the interstitial lamellae. Now the interstitial lamellae actually represent concentric lamellae that have been partly resorbed and remodeled and no longer surround a Haversian canal. During bone formation, when the organic matrix is laid down by osteoblasts, they often get buried within the lamellae and are housed in small cavities called lacunae. Osteoblasts are housed in lacunae and are called osteocytes, and they have delicate cytoplasmic processes radiating out that are housed in microcanals called canaliculi. Now these canaliculi are interconnecting and help osteocytes contact adjacent osteocytes as well as the osteoblasts lining the bone surface. The outermost layer of the compact bone is surrounded by a periosteum having two layers, an outer fibrous layer and an inner layer facing the bone, having precursor bone cells as well as a rich blood supply. Now the Haversian canals communicate with each other as well as the periosteum and the marrow space via canals called Wokman canals. So Wokman canals, like Haversian canals, also contain blood vessels. And this system of interconnected Haversian and Wokman canals supplies nutrients, nourishes the bone, and keeps it vital. Now the innermost layer of the compact bone is called the endosteum. The innermost layer faces the medullary cavity that houses a fine network of bony spicules called the cancellous bone or trabecular bone. These spicules of trabecular bone are interconnecting and their ends are attached to the endosteum. And like the compact bone, the trabecular bone is also made of lamellae that are concentric. However, trabecular bone does not have osteons like in the compact bone. The alveolar bone, also called the alveolar process, is the elevated ridge of the maxilla and the mandible where the teeth are housed. Now, strictly speaking, there is no defined boundary between the body of the jaws and the alveolar process. The alveolar bone or process can be divided into an alveolar bone proper and a supporting alveolar bone. So the alveolar bone proper is the bone forming the tooth socket or the alveolus that surrounds the roots of the tooth. Histologically, it is a compact bone having osteons. It is also called a bundle bone since bundles of principal periodontal ligament fibers called Sharpey's fibers attach to the bone from the tooth. The alveolar bone proper or the alveolar sockets have numerous small perforations of canals that carry nerves and blood vessels. Hence, the alveolar bone proper is also called the cribriform plate. The interdental and the interradicular septa are also cribriform plates and house numerous canals called canals of Zucker-Cantle and Hirschfield. In radiographs, the alveolar bone proper is more radiodense than the surrounding bone and can be seen as a thin radiopaque bone surrounding the roots of the teeth. Radiographically, the alveolar bone proper is called lamina dura, and its increased radiodensity is not because of high mineral content, but due to the bone being thick and not having trabeculations. Now, the rest of the alveolar process gives support to the alveolar bone proper and is called the supporting alveolar bone. The supporting alveolar bone consists of buccal and lingual cortical plates and trabecular or cancellous bone in between the cortical plates as well as the alveolar bone proper. The cortical plates of the mandible are thicker than the maxilla, since maxillary cortex has numerous pores where many blood vessels and nerves traverse. Also, the maxilla has more trabecular bone than the mandible. The trabecular bone, according to its arrangement in the alveolar process, is divided into two types called type 1 and type 2. The type 1 trabecular bone has a horizontal or a ladder-like arrangement and is usually more prominent than the mandible, whereas the type 2 is an irregularly arranged trabecular bone and is more common in the maxilla.